past ya. I won't put it past ya. I said ride the wave, but you sank the ship so fast, yeah. You weren't on my side because that would make you mad, yeah. I ain't gotta lie, girl, I loved you more the past, yeah. But thinking about it, six side trips down to see you by the coast. I would say I love looking better than for most. I used to show you pictures to my friends just to boast about your energy, ooh, yeah. And that 4.0, yeah. Never thought I had to look again. Way too focused on your ex and them. Really think you need some better friends. I've been feeling different ever since. You won't ever find a better man. Loved you way more than you ever knew. Now I'm looking for a better you. I said, whoa, I'm on my own. He spoke on the phone. That's all she wrote. She said, leave me alone. So I'ma go. Spending all our time and we went for broke. But you could've made it last year. I won't put it past ya. I said ride the wave, but you sank the ship so fast, yeah. You weren't on my side because that would make you mad, yeah. I ain't gotta lie, girl, I loved you more the past, yeah. But thinking about it, six side trips, come and see me in the veil. Making love to you first to show you how I feel. We connected on a level, thought that I could never build. And I was so impressed with you. But you know everything that's good has an end. Look what you created, now we're in this happenstance. I'm convinced you never really loved me truly like you said you did. It won't be your friends that would be there in the end, no. It could've been me, it could've been me. It could've been us, we could've been free. A date in New York, yeah. A date on the beach. Nobody else would know what that means except you and me. I swear that I meant it, I get it, you needed your peace. But do not forget it, you need a release. You cried in my arms, I need you to breathe. Where were you at when I needed you, please? Oh, when I needed you. And I said, whoa. We spoke on the phone, so she wrote. She said, leave me alone, so I'ma go. Spending all our time and we went for broke. But you could've made it last, yeah. I wouldn't put it past you, yeah. It's the right away. Take the ship so fast, yeah. You were on my side. No, no, no.
Previously on a live tasting, this is what I tasted. Ugh. Oh. Oh. I am not drinking that. That is just, it smells like this has been sitting next to like a dude's cat. Like a dead, it smells like a dead cat meets, you know, fermented chewing tobacco. Okay, here's the part that matters. Let's go in for the taste. Mmm. Oh, yeah. Oh, ho, ho. Wow. Talk about, Brown sugar, butter just dripping on down the palate, down the jawline, tickling the roof of my mouth with a little bit of cinnamon. And then on that back end, just, it's funny, like it's a spicy caramel.
But just, there's some hints of like floral, there's some hints of like something like a honeysuckle. Damn. But a lot of caramel.
Oh, man.
That's the kind of taste that makes me want to close the computer down, stop working, find a campfire and some buddies, and just sit there and talk, because my God, it's good.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to tonight's tasting. It's a battle between Elijah Craig Barrel Proof B520 against Larceny Barrel Proof B520. Now, it's actually not a battle. They're from the same family. Very different whiskeys indeed, but I'm going to taste them. Last time I didn't like Larceny Barrel Proof too much, but I did fall in love with the last batch of Elijah Craig. And it's actually on my list for whiskey of the year so far. So I am really excited about tonight. Get those comments in. I'm going to be checking them as much as I possibly can. And I'm going to be putting them up on here. And I'm, we see here some people a little nervous about me talking about turkey. Well, John, this was going to be my calibration whiskey, but I don't want John out there nervous. That wouldn't be good. You can't have that. So, all right. So I'm gonna pick a different calibration whiskey. This was going to be it. But so now I'm going to go to, well, you know what? I see a bottle of Weller Antique there. I think we all know that I can't do any damage to that one. It's not opened. Probably need to open it. And I do happen to know the flavor of Weller Antique pretty well. So we're going to pour that in here. I'm going to get my palate calibrated. Get it ready for tonight. We got some important breakdowns to do. And then, you know, who knows? Might just do a bonus tasting. So I want to thank everyone for coming in tonight. I have some really big news, some fun announcements. YouTube has made this, on the YouTube side, has made this a member channel. And I just made that available late last night. And happy to say we've already got a healthy membership community building. But what you do, how you become a member, is you just click join, and you can join for as little as $1.99. Some behind-the-scenes stuff. You get access to some fun emojis. You know, if you're on YouTube right now, you'll get to see the emojis throughout the chat. But it's all content-driven, okay? So there's not any barrel picks or anything like that. This is not like Patreon. This isn't like you know, some of those other things. This is all about content. I'm going to be providing members only live streams, and I'm also going to give people knowledge to my Whiskeys of the Year contenders before I announce them publicly. So there's going to be a lot of fun things that we're going to do. You're also going to get to vote on what I taste in the live streams, and I'm really, really excited about this, because, you know, YouTube is one of the hardest mediums that I have ever tackled. And it's one of those things, it doesn't matter who you are. You know, I just interviewed Harry Scherer, who is the he's the voice of Ned Flanders and Mr. Burns on The Simpsons. He's got a YouTube channel, and he's just starting. And he's like seeing the same thing. He's like trying to get people over there. But YouTube is the beast that is very difficult to figure out. But I am so proud that this community has allowed me, given me the opportunity to indeed become a member channel, so I can provide some more cool, exclusive content. It won't always be as well produced as some of the other stuff, but hey, iPhones take really good videos. So let's get calibrated here. Whew, yeah, this fresh bottle of Weller Antique, smelling really good. Smelling very smelling very crazy caramel forward. Oh yeah, that is really, really, really good. So we have a lot of people in tonight. I'm really glad you all came to join this channel. We are a community. This past weekend, for whiskey from home, we had a ton of people. Bourbon Pursuit's gonna be making a larger announcement about that here pretty soon. But thank you to all of you who came to Whiskey from Home. That was a great example of how bourbon is truly a community, and how together we can get through this kind of like isolation period. And tonight we have a really great opportunity to taste two bourbons that have not been put out. This is these were sent to me by Heaven Hill. Last week I talked with Matthew Raywalt, formerly Aiden English of the WWE, about like why some people stop sending bottles and when they give a bad review. Heaven Hill's never done that to me. So I gave the last Larceny a pretty bad review, and they sent me another one. So here I am. I'm going to taste these, and we'll see what I think. So here we go. Actually, why don't I go to the chat here, make sure that I'm not missing any good questions. So if you guys have some questions, Prop Pros from Periscope talking about how Whiskey from Home was awesome. Thank you for tuning in. That was definitely a great one to put on. We love doing it, and I'm glad so many people watched it. Are you drinking tap water or limestone water in between sips of bourbon? Right now I'm drinking tap water. I'm not that fancy with my water. Hey Chris, what's going on, man? Good to see you. Thanks for that, Tim. I really appreciate it. Rebecca Page asked, do all distilleries replace bad bottles? You know what they tend. What has happened before is there have been recalls in the past. It's often for legal reasons. But usually, what they will do is they will take the bottle, they will take the liquid, and they will put it into something that they can sell as GNS or sell off to an ethanol plant or something that can be distilled down even more. So they have a lot of stuff that's going on. I have another question here. Fred, sir, what's the blue bottle near your right arm, middle on the shelf? This one? That one? Or this one? This is Montagna Rum. Didn't give that a very high review, actually. And that is Fourgate Batch 6, which I did actually kind of fall in love with. Yo mama. Hey, yo mama. Always good to see yo mama on the feed. Excellent job at Whiskey from Home. Will you try the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof A120 versus B520 to compare tonight? You know what? that is a really good, that's a really good suggestion for a bonus round. I think if we have enough people coming in with those emojis, especially the Vodka Sucks ones, I think that one is going to definitely gotta win me over. If I can find the bottle. Actually, I do not know where the bottle is. What's up, Bourbon Lens? Everybody, Bourbon Lens, a fine bourbon podcast. Go check them out. Really good folks. Yes, Vodka Sucks. You cannot say Vodka Sucks enough on this program. I really appreciate that. As you know, I have a barrel head behind me. We also have an emoji that if you are a member of the YouTube community, you can use it. So go to go to YouTube, become a member, and use the emoji like Rebecca just did here. Vodka Sucks. It's funny because really, you know, when it comes to Vodka Sucks, it's really more of a, you know, it, today was a big win for vodka. They're able to say they taste like something, but rest assured, vodka, you still suck. Look at all these Vodka Sucks coming in. This is fantastic. We got Douglas coming in with the Vodka Sucks, Greg Bradshaw, Danny Lynn, Jacob. Look at this. This is beautiful. Okay, so Elijah Craig Barrel Proof. Guys, this is probably the most consistent and most consistent of the limited edition releases year after year after year. Now, you will find in the notes what is what these are all about. Now, I did not create little things to put in the window like I normally do because I was busy making that video. Not gonna lie, that video took a lot of time to make. So it distracted me from making the informative charts that I normally make. I do know that in my notes in each one of these, you will find the materials that you're looking for. I do recall that the Larceny is 8 years range, and the Elijah Craig, of course, is 12 years old. But the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof is the most consistent, in my opinion, of being a stellar product of the limited edition products. Like, I have never had a bad Elijah Craig Barrel Proof. Have I had some more than I liked? Have I had some that I like more than others? Oh, absolutely. I mean, who hasn't? But this is always a fantastic, fantastic. Oh, boy. Boy, at home dad is really getting on it. He's really getting on that Vodka Sucks emoji. Nothing wrong with that. Keep it up. Keep it up. I like it. I like it. Mark Hagan in the house. He's from my cigar club. He is not the person who sent me the Elmer T. Lee cork taint. That was someone else. Fortunately, that person has made up for his offenses. By the way, he sent that like 2 days before my Mick Fleetwood interview. And the whole purpose of me interviewing these these musicians is that I'm tasting with them. And I was like, I think my palate's blown out. So, yeah, we're going here. Fred, be prepared for serious emoji spam, brother. A lot of it. Okay. Giddy up for that. So here we go with the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof B520. So I see a comment in here that I'm a little out of focus. Let me know if that is if that remains. Okay, so the nose. This nose is actually atypical for an Elijah Craig Barrel Proof nose for me. Okay, so usually these tend to be very caramel leaning, and they tend to be I don't know, like sweet smelling. This is going down an opposite road. This is going down a spice road, something that I would expect more out of like a Four Roses. And in fact, if I was nosing this blindly, my first instinct was that this was going to be a Four Roses. So here we go. Of course, we've got a whole new distiller there. You know, Connor is a guy that is definitely doing things his way, and he's a man who likes his rye. Okay, I'm going in for what smells like a spicy treat. Okay. Definitely spicy smelling. Definitely spicy on the palate. You know, first taste, we'll come back to it. I mean, I don't want to sully anyone's thoughts here. Oh, that's my, I don't want to drink out of that. Okay. All right. I don't know how I feel about this one. I think this is one of the problems of having preconceived notions of when you go in to taste something. And this is why I always try to tell people when you're blindly tasting, don't try to think about what you are tasting. Don't try to pick the brand, because in your mind, you have a flavor profile for that particular brand. And you just kind of keep going down that what your pathway has put you down. And I actually came into this with the thought that I was about to taste Elijah Craig Barrel Proof, when in fact what I tasted does not remind me at all of past Elijah Craig Barrel Proofs. That's not good or bad. That's just a fact of what I just tasted. And I know that, you know, I feel like my palate is not off because I calibrated it with something previously that I know and understand. And so let's go to Larceny Barrel Proof. You know, Larceny to me is the, so this is 122.2 proof. Larceny to me is one of the ultimate modern American whiskey stories. Okay, so it's based on some folklore from American whiskey history that has a little bit of truth to it. But the fact of the matter is, Heaven Hill had a brand that was not really moving, not as exciting in the times, called Old Fitzgerald. Yes, the geeks loved it and all that, but this bottle is way sexier than that old Fitzgerald bottle. They basically took the liquid that was being used for Old Fitzgerald and put it in this bottle. And this bottle, this brand and everything, was all concepted by women. I wrote about that in my book, Whiskey Women, The Untold Story of How Women Saved Bourbon, Scotch, and Irish Whiskey. And you should go check that out. Paperback's coming out here soon. We got Linda Beam in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Linda Beam. Nobody did it like Parker. No, they did not. Of course, everybody knows how I love me some Linda Beam, and I love talking about Parker Beam. And I do not think Parker would have distilled this one. So this is 6 to 8 years old. There's a small chance that he might have distilled this whiskey, and a very good chance that Craig did. Of course, Craig. All right, Larry Cass, who's in the Bourbon Hall of Fame, he's like, actually, Fred, I named it. That is true. Larry actually used to do most of the work at Heaven Hill, and everyone else got the credit for it. He was the behind the scenes man, the best at the job. Miss you, Larry. Now, this is a nose I can get really excited about. What I dig about this nose is it's cotton candy. I love cotton candy. When I was a kid, I would get cotton candy at the fair. I'd get it at, you know, when I was working at Frontier City, which, by the way, if anybody on this stream is from Oklahoma, you know Frontier City very well. I was the wait guesser over by the Silver Bullet. So I used to guess people's weight, the month they were born, and how old they were. I mean, it's a ripoff. I mean, you paid $2, and if you won, you got a 50-cent prize. But it's a great way to pick up girls when you were 17. Why, yes, I do look like I love cotton candy, Greg Bradshaw. I am a rotund man. Got the tire. I like this nose. Again, cotton candy. I'm getting some vanilla, some chocolates. This is a really, really nice, really, really nice nose. Huge improvement for me from the last one. Huge improvement. Jeff Hodges asked, did I wear an ascot when I was working at Frontier City guessing people's weight? Actually, we had to wear a bandana, so it was kind of like an ascot. Rebecca Page asked, so was there a hidden scale that helped you guess their weight? Actually, no. I was just really good. But I would put my foot on the scale, just kind of mess with them a little bit. So like if someone came in, was like really, really tiny, I would put my foot on there and then they would be like, you know, end up weighing 225 when they were, you know, 140. So I did stuff like that and people always got a good laugh at it. So in case you're just joining us, we're going down the road of when I used to be a weight guesser at Frontier City. And the times I had there as a 17-year-old fresh out of high school on my way to Oklahoma State, thin with muscles, hair that could grow, eyes that would pierce through. Okay, I'll stop reminiscing those days. God, I'm really digging this Larceny. All right. Cotton candy. Pumpkin pie. Some like cinnamon red hots. I mean, it's a really nice cinnamon note here. Man, that's good. There's a few other things going on. There's a few other things going on here. I don't really know what this is. What I'm getting here is I'm getting a lot of like pie related stuff. So like pie crusts, pie filling, like some of the chocolate pie fillings and stuff. But the pumpkin pie note and cinnamon and cotton candy, those are the three predominant notes for me. So this tastes like Thanksgiving. I mean, this is... I mean, minus the cotton candy, I guess. I know that I want to pick up and keep tasting the Larceny, but here we are really with the objective to taste both, and so I need to go back and taste the Elijah Craig. Uh, Shem, I did not like Larceny A120. I did not like it one bit. I did not like it one bit. Yo Mama asked if I picked up any marzipan in that. I did not. I did not pick up any marzipan. But thank you for asking, Yo Mama. Okay. I'm going to re-pour. I'm going to go ahead and re-pour the Elijah Craig into another glass. I picked up a hint of soap in that glass. And I don't know if the glass may have just, you know, thrown off the thrown it off. Now, you all will know from previous episodes that I have smelled soap before and switched glasses. I've been doing a very, very good job with my dishes lately. So, if there was soap on there, it was just pure coincidence. Brendan asks, when might the YouTube membership subscription show itself? Brendan, it's available now. All you got to do is you'll see subscribe, and then you'll see join. You just click join, and then you join that. Nice and easy. Very different. Very different nose. A much more... Much more promising, but still not the typical Elijah Craig nose for me. This nose very much smells of cinnamon and very in different types of baking spices. I'm getting clove. I'm getting nutmeg. I'm getting Chinese allspice, which Chinese allspice is not something I actually get in a lot of whiskeys. And then oak. Yeah. Very inviting palate. It's actually really there's like a hint of tobacco there that comes in afterward, after you felt the depth of some sweetness and that spice. And it's like a good cigar. Like you feel the moisture around, it's kind of right there at the side of your cheek, and you can feel that tingle. It's a lot like that. This is a good mouthfeel bourbon. But the finish is very, very quick. In comparison to the Larceny has a more developed finish. It lingers much, much longer. But they both have a lot of flavor going on. And I'm going to go ahead and discount that very first taste I took of the Elijah Craig. I think, you know, I just had a bad glass. And that threw my nose off. And then threw off my palate. And also, you know, again, I mentioned this at the top, but you can't discount the fact that you have a mindset of what something should taste like when you're going in to taste it. So I went back into it with a little bit more of an open mind and really, really dig it. I agree. I should be wearing the Matlock suit more often. Okay. Well, we know whoever I pick is my favorite for the night. The distiller is going to win, right? It's all made by Heaven Hill. Heaven Hill is a great distillery. Here's another great, this is another great suggestion for tonight's bonus round. So, like, anybody who has the capability to do, like, a vodka sucks emoji, nominate what you'd like to see as the bonus round tonight. I think we saw the Elijah Craig, the last release versus this one. And then also the Makers versus the Larceny Barrel Proof. Okay, you know, that spice is really just warming. It's there's so much really nice cinnamon action going on back palate. Well, there at the same time, there's some sweetness going on, but I'm still leaning toward the Larceny tonight. I'm finding the Larceny to be far more complex, to have a longer finish, to be more, you know, right for tonight. Oh, yeah. This is a very easy one for me. This is a very, very easy one for me. The Larceny cask strength, or barrel proof as they call it, is phenomenal. Barrel proof B520 is an excellent, excellent pour. And the thing is it has a lot of different flavors and it's doing a lot of different things to my tongue. I can feel it. I can feel it probably on 3/4 of my tongue. And then when I just think it's about to like erode, it hits that other quarter. So it hits every inch of my tongue. Now you'll hear me talk about like a lot of bourbons that like drip down the jawline. This one doesn't do that. This one penetrates the tongue and stays on the tongue. It doesn't come down. It doesn't go up. But it continues to develop and, you know, create flavors. Even now as I talk, I can still feel it finishing on the back end. And that is extremely promising. So really, 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 really glad that... Oh, so Rebecca Page asks, what's the alcohol percentage here? So it is 122.2 proof or... 61.1% alcohol. All right, guys. So it's a pretty easy pick for me tonight. I'm going to pick the Larceny. Barrel proof wins handedly over its sister bourbon in Elijah Craig B520. I do find that this is promising. It does have a lot of depth to it, but it does not hit the mark for me for the majority of the Elijah Craig's barrel proofs that I have tasted. Perhaps it's because I'm coming off one of the best Elijah Craig barrel proofs I have ever tasted in A120. But at the same time, I stand by my thought that this does not kind of meet that normal profile that I expect in here. Okay, so some bonus round suggestions. I've only seen, now if you're not a member, go hit that join button and become a member. That is kind of, that's my best way of following, like, who can, like, make a nomination and vote on the bonus tastings, because they appear differently, and I have a lot of texts and everything coming in. So here we go. We've got we have another vote for I have the A120 500 pizzas, but I don't have the 519. I think that's gone. But I saw some other suggestions to see if the Larceny Barrel Proof would hold up against the Maker's Mark Cask Strength. So we have a lot of recommendations for Dant versus Old Crow. You guys make the assumption that I have Old Crow, the rot gut, the brand stripped, beautiful brand that it used to be in my office, which I don't. They have bastardized that brand, and it breaks my heart. Okay, let's see. I'm not seeing any more suggestions, so I'm probably going to go with the Greg Bradshaw votes for Larceny versus Pappy. That's fine. I am looking forward to sending your Pappy over to me, Greg. That would be very nice of you to do. Shame on you, Greg. Okay, guys, so I am going to go ahead. So Rare Bird, whom I know is a member, he is suggesting to do a Booker's Taste Off against these two products. We have a Larceny versus Bellamede. More Bookers. I don't have the latest Bookers. You guys just want me to grab a Booker's and sip it? You want a comparative? Another Booker's? Okay. I will sip another Booker's. I will find a Booker's, but guys, I talks amongst yourself here about what you want. You want a comparative between a Booker's versus Larceny? Yeah, I'll look. I know I have Booker's in the office. I just don't know where it is. All right, so here we go. Let me give you guys some music. I failed you by not playing you your favorite song while I was gone. Now keep the chat going. Use those emojis, members, and tell people how they can use them too. Take long? You sure you can handle? That did not take long. Okay. So we've got this is Booker's 7 years, 2 months, batch C07B7. 138 proof. I hate that stuff. I hate the glue they put on the back of it. Yeah, I have a lot of old stuff in the office. Okay. It's going to be right behind me there, so you can see it. Woo! Ho-ho! Some bitch. Man. For those of you just joining us, we are now in the bonus round where the members will nominate things for me to taste. After I have concluded my, competition, and I will taste them. All right, I'm going to give the number once again. Somebody take notes so they can share with someone as they join, and in case they missed it. It is a 7-year-old, 2-month batch number C. That's C as in Charlie, 07, B as in Bravo. 7, C, 0, 7, B, 7. So please re-mention that in the chat if someone asks. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Cornbread straight out of the oven, butter on it. Caramel just developing right on there. Cinnamon popping in toward the back. Damn. That is son of a bitchin' good. You know? There's a reason why my wife steals all our Bookers, because it's good. I did have the honor of sitting on the round table once, of selecting one of the Bookers that they released, but I didn't realize how much like press and everything it would get, like, and I felt very, very uncomfortable about it. And so I was like, you know what? I don't want to be associated with a brand. And, you know, and we went in there fully knowing that there were like 10 journalists, you know, who had known Booker or have written about, you know, bourbon extensively. And we knew that we were picking one, but I had no intention of writing about it or anything like that. And it was weird. I don't do things with brands. I like being objective and separate from them. But Booker's, I will not lie, has always been a household favorite. And it's largely because my wife, she is an enormous Booker's fan. All right. So there's a note in here that is really unique to Booker's. And I believe it is the note that some people will interpret as like almond paste, honey, but it is indeed marzipan. A lot of Booker's products have that beautiful, wonderful, gorgeous marzipan note. And this one, oh, it's got it. It's got the marzipan. It is so good. I almost want to stop the recording tonight and just sip on that. Call up my buddies. Well, wait. I can't do that. I can't call my buddies anymore. So going to Larceny. What bourbon would I wear as a cologne? Well, it depends on if I'm driving, because there's always a chance you're going to get pulled over. And I don't know if I want to smell like bourbon. But if I'm out on a stroll, if I'm out trying to pick up my wife or whatever, because my wife does like the smell of bourbon, I would probably say I would want to smell like a Willett Rickhouse. Of all the bourbon smells that are out there in the world, I think Willett Rickhouses smell the best. Like, there's just something unique about a Willett Rickhouse. There's just a smell in there that I don't get in another warehouses. So, I guess douse me in some of that 53-gallon Willett. Ah, man, I almost said that. Douse me in a 53-gallon barrel of Willet. Okay. Whoever came up with the idea to do this comparative between Booker's and Larceny, you were friggin' brilliant. You were absolutely brilliant. Because what you did was you took the idea of, you know, the cash strength, you know, and how it hits your palate and all that, and you said, all right, what is the cash strength product that we can get or whatever? And I see it right behind him, apparently. And what is the one that we can compare to these? And you picked one that's not too dissimilar from the Elijah Craig, with the exception that the Elijah Craig is 5 years older. So what we have here is we have a bourbon that is very close in age to the Larceny. And, I do like tequila. I like tequila a lot. But I don't think it's a place for anybody to say what a real man does or doesn't. You'd be shocked what a man will do when he has to do it. I've been in a lot of places, and I've learned it's best not to judge someone based on what they drink. Unless it's White Claw or vodka. You know what? Don't judge them based on vodka, but definitely White Claw. Okay, the Booker's wins that round. I don't really, that Booker's was jumping all over my palate. I am not a fan of Kirk and Sweeney, but I hope you enjoy it. I hope you enjoy that cocktail. Okay, so I saw there was another suggestion, and I'm feeling it. I'm on. I'm good. So if you all would like to see another bullet, another bonus tasting, I see the recommendation for a Weller Full Proof. Do you all see Weller Full Proof in here? Because I don't. I'm looking for Weller Full Proof. Brendan, I didn't mean to squash your hopes. I didn't mean that. That was rude of me. I will say that I do believe that I tend to be very opinionated. And when I say I don't like something, I really don't like it. It is true. I really don't like it. But I do not want that to stop you from finding out for yourself. It's an exploration. It's a journey. It's about learning. And I apologize for that. I really do. I got to get better about that. I do. I have to get better about how I say I don't like something. Because, honestly, I really don't like that stuff. I do not like Kirk and Sweeney. But I do believe that what I don't like, someone else will. And here's the thing. I just put this up on YouTube today. Everybody hates something. Everybody hates some type of whiskey. So, here we go. Rebecca Page, Rebecca, she writes, in this, in some ways, it breaks my heart. I'm sorry to say that I had vodka yesterday after a guy said I should try a Moscow Mule, but I have to say I prefer a Mamie Taylor Moore. It's okay. Vodka sucks. Members, please blow it up with vodka sucks emojis in memory of Rebecca's one time of having a vodka. Now, hey, guys, I got to find this Weller foolproof if I'm going to taste this up against this particular Booker's. I know I have one in here somewhere. And I definitely have some at the house. But we may be on the outs for this one. Behind the antique? No? Antique's right here. That's Catoctin Creek. Let me go check in the office, or on that side. Vodka sucks. I'll be right back. Hey, looky here. Look what I found. I found a Weller Full Proof that we can do a side-by-side on, and I got two new glasses, so win double me. So we are tasting. Now, should we taste the Larceny up against Weller Full Proof? Let's bring this up in the chat here, folks. Let's bring this up in the chat. Danny's, did I not give you guys music? I apologize. I'm so focused on finding the whiskey you all are making me drink. Guys, I think the this is funny. Andrew says the pouring won't stop, can't stop. So what we need to do, we really do have, I feel more comfortable starting out with the Weller versus Larceny. And then I'll take that, if Weller wins, then I will take that up against the Booker's. But let me tell you why. That Booker's, and I do remember it, and I know why it is in my office. It's because this was really, really good. It's one of my favorites. And I think it's in my office to hide from my wife because she liked it too. And I won't, it's true. Like my wife, she drinks the good stuff. And when I'm out of town, which is not happening right now, I have to hide my good bourbon. And we've made an agreement that we will not drink the good bourbon in the house unless we're both there. And we talk more about that in an upcoming episode of the Curation Desk. And there was a whole thing about the Dallas Cowboys and herpes and all that. You guys got to watch that. Okay, so here we are with the Weller Full Proof. I feel like the consensus was, it's going against this. Doesn't that sound good? All right. So, we've had both these before. We know right here we have Weller, or over here we have Weller, who's the challenger tonight. Weller's done well in past tastings. Larceny, on the other hand, the barrel proof, the previous barrel proof, did not do so well. And here we are with the latest edition of the Larceny barrel proof. And it did pretty well. Okay. We have a question in here. Is this a recommendation for a new person? So if you are a new person in bourbon, and you're looking at jumping in for with like cast strength and stuff, this is a question that you need to answer for yourself. How well do you deal with like really spicy food? If you don't deal well with spicy food, then you need to come in at a lower proof. If you do well with spicy food, like let's say you like the spicier Indian foods, spicier Chinese foods, spicier Mexican foods, then jump in feet first, start Booker's, go downward. So that would be my recommendation for you if you are a new bourbon drinker. But if you don't like spicy food, that means your tongue might be sensitive to the spice or what some might interpret as alcohol burn. So you need a palate that can take a little bit of hot sauce on there. So if you like hot sauce, you can do it. Also, take a look at the comment section. You have to remember, it's been a long time since I've been a newbie in the bourbon world. Okay. These noses are pretty equal. Got the cotton candy dance over here. Got the caramel over here. So we got cotton candy versus caramel. Cotton candy, caramel. Love them both. Let's taste. That larceny just really feels so good on the palate. So good. Guys, oh, it's so good. Wow. This is so hard. This is the kind of decision you don't want to have to make in your life. Between two really good bourbons to take on potentially a great bourbon. Is it fair to the bourbon? Is it fair to you? I don't know. Oh, we got a cool beard emoji coming in. What up? All right. The Weller has, I apologize for not speaking while I was tasting those two times, but when you see me doing that, I really do have to concentrate. I really do have to focus. And so just know that I'm thinking about what I can tell you about what I'm tasting that's different between the two. The Weller has a really prominent astringency note there toward the end, which is very, very different than the larceny note toward the end. So if you like astringent, if you like tobacco, if you like wood, if you like oversmoked like chicken, or if you like really, really, really smoky things, I think you might lean toward the Weller in this situation, but I necessarily do not. I found that to be, like, when I'm comparing them side by side, I found that to be a flaw. And the barrel proof did beat that. So I do find that the Larceny Barrel Proof was better than the, and this is a barrel pick too, by the way. I found the Larceny Barrel Proof to be slightly better. And by the way, that astringency note was really, really hard to detect, but it was there. But this is a barrel pick and really, 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 really good. But Larceny just edged it just a little bit. So, yeah, I mean, basically, Bruin brings it out really nicely. The Weller Barrel Proof, hands down, better with a cigar. Without a doubt. Without a doubt. This is a great cigar bourbon. Without a doubt. No doubt about it. Okay, so I got one more in me, folks. I got one more in me. So if we have a member who wants to make a nomination, then we'll do it. Right now, the reigning champion for the night, the reigning champ, is this this Booker's from some time ago. It did defeat the Larceny. The Larceny, however, really holding its own up against everything else. And this is some really, 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 really good stuff. But I mean, you're looking at a Booker's that's no longer in existence. It just happened to be behind me. And everyone keeps bringing up the Maker's Cash Strength. I'll be honest with you. I know Maker's Cash Strength well, and I don't think it would compare well against Larceny. I mean, I could do it if the votes came in for it, but I would rather find something in here that would take this on. I'm thinking you guys need to think big. Think big and see what you like that might come up against this guy. No Blanton's in the office. I saw a note come in for Blanton's. Not really a Blanton's guy. $2.91. People want $2.91. Now, I do have $2.91 in here. Now, I do think that is a particular bourbon that is really, really important for the future of American whiskey, because they do have a lot of different types of wood that they play with, like aspen. A lot of people don't play with that. Really, really good. Oh, Jason Day. Oh, I mean, good God, you guys are coming in so fast, I can't find the comment. Jason Day recommended I go up against the Booker's that I just tasted, up against the Elijah Craig A120. The Elijah Craig A120 that I was over the moon for. Jason Manita writes, he would like to see Fourgate Batch 6 versus Booker's. Man, I don't think that's a fair comparison. But that Fourgate, this shit is motherfucking good. Motherfucking good. We got a nomination here for 1792 Foolproof. Need to be hearing from my members here. Make sure you guys are using your emojis. Use those emojis. I do have a smoke wagon. I have a smoke wagon barrel pick. Keep those comments coming in. I would love to find out what you guys want to taste. What would you like me to taste? I got one more taste in me. Jack Daniel's Barrel Proof is getting a lot of things, a lot of comments here. I'm just telling you all, guys, you need to pick something that is... You need to pick something that is good, like really, really good. And you know that I like it because it will not defeat this Booker's unless it is really, really good. People are saying the Smoke Wagon. I did like the Smoke Wagon, but folks, I don't know if I liked it this much. I don't know. I think the best vote we have here is the Elijah Craig. The Elijah Craig A120. I do not have the Stag Junior Batch 12. That has came in a lot. I don't have Little Book Chapter 3. I think I'm all out of Stag. So here we go, folks. We got the Zip It one here. Look at that. Okay, so I am going to look for one that I'm surprised that no one has brought up is a barrel product. So barrel, my 2018 American Whiskey of the Year is like right behind me. And no one's brought that up. But I will go for looking for the Elijah Craig A120. It is a contender for the American Whiskey of the Year for me right now. And I almost feel, We got a nomination for the Pursuit Series 23. That's a fair one. That's a fair one. But I think I drink it all. Pretty sure I did. Yes, barrel 15. So, all right, everybody. Let's make the decision together. I think we're going to go ahead and go with some A120. I'm gonna take you on a ride. We're gonna burn through the night. Why you're so salty? I'll still say goodbye. This is, however, my last tasting for the evening. So, all those who have become members, thank you so much. If you're not a member, we're going to be doing some live streams more that are like this. There will be a time that these are going to be members-only live streams. And right now, like I like send videos of like before I do stuff. And providing a lot of old content to include like some interviews from old Stetzel Weller executives from old, you know, distillers, all kinds of stuff. Now, this will not take it out of contention if the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof A120 loses tonight. Because this is not from this year. Oh boy, that Elijah Craig A120, it's just all up in my nose. I'm getting coconut. I'm getting so much beauty in this thing. This is a work of art from a nose perspective. Whoever asked me earlier, you know, it was Rebecca Page. She asked me earlier, what whiskey would you cover yourself in, you know, to smell for perfume or whatever? I think it'd be Elijah Craig A120. I did say it would be a well-lit barrel, just pour it all up on me, but if I had to pick one bottle, this is so, so beautiful. Oh, damn.
That caramel.
Oh. That is motherfucking son of a bitch and good. Damn. Ah, Greg. All right, so let's go back to the Bookers. Well, nice. It's starting to feel like a AAA pitcher now after nosing that thing. It's like I just went from Roger Clemens in 2001, and now I'm going to like some AAA pitcher who just got called up to the Reds and brought back down because of elbow soreness. But he still's got it. He's still got a pretty good 96 mile an hour fastball and a curveball. But his changeup sucks. Guys, this is really good. The Booker's is really good, but you asked me to come in for a bonus round. This is the best thing that I have tasted tonight. The A120 is absolutely gorgeous. It wipes the floor with every single thing I've tasted. It's not even close. Wow. Oh, good God. Motherfucking son of a bitch. That is so good. Well, I want to thank everyone for joining tonight. I want to thank you all so much for a very healthy chat from Twitch to DLive and Facebook and Periscope to, of course, YouTube, where the membership begins. You come to YouTube and you can become a member of the channel. And listen, I did not go into YouTube thinking that I would start a membership channel, but I'm not going to lie. This is a time where basically in my entire like live events business has been just wiped away, just completely gone. Bourbon and Beyond, all my private tastings, everything. But I must like talk about whiskey. I have to do this. I have to educate people. I love educating people. I used to just go to like random bars and just stand there and talk to people. I wouldn't even tell them who I was. I wouldn't even give them a book. I wouldn't sign a book. I wouldn't talk about my books. I would just talk about whiskey because this is something that I absolutely 1000% love doing. And I'm doing everything that I can to take what I did in person to bring to a virtual world. And YouTube allowing me the opportunity to have like a membership channel, it's huge in so many ways. It's huge in the perspective of like, one, it actually does allow me to make a living doing what I love. And two, I get to talk. I get to talk about the things that I love that I would do if I was with you in front of a table of six people eating and sipping bourbon. I mean, I love what I do. I love educating people about this. But this community right now has helped me get through a very, very difficult time for all of us. But anybody who's in the live events business knows that this is one of the big pendulums of just, we don't know what's going to happen next. And I have built my entire like business around, everything that I've done has been about standing in front of people and talking about bourbon and sipping bourbon with them. That's been my business for the last 5 years. And I am so fortunate. I'm so thankful that we have a community that embraces people who want to learn more. And I hope you'll join me. I hope you'll join me on this like quest, this journey to learn more, become part of this like community a little deeper. We're still going to be here, but just come in a little deeper and you'll just see what it's all about. It's only just beginning. This is the first night, to be honest with you. It's the first night that I've had a membership channel. It's kind of cool. And some people, it takes 3 years, 6 years to get there. I'm so thankful that YouTube gave me this opportunity to be here like 6 months. So thank you. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. And remember, this is very important. Don't lick trash cans. Don't lick handrails. And vodka sucks unless it's being used for hand sanitizer. Cheers, everybody. Have a good night.